10%.
Only?
But you're just only the contact.
But Joe...
No buts.
Fine. What's my cut? In cash?
How else will I pay you?
Oh, I just got in. Which was... Do I go? Or do I wait for you at the reception? Okay.
Have we met?
I would have remembered.
Me too. Joe Kairu is my name.
Oh, Joe. I see. Yeah. I'm here to see Elsie Kamona.
Please have a seat.
Thank you.
So?
Hold your horses, buddy. She's with me.
There were two and now there are three.
Tell me.
My former employer, XP Telecommunication, is suing me for 3 million shillings.
3 million? What for?
Breach of contract. Because currently I'm working for another telecommunication company, they want me to compensate them 3 million big ones.
It sounds ridiculous, but it's plausible.
You mean I may be forced to pay the 3 million?
Was it stipulated in the contract that you signed when you joined them?
Yes, it was.
Then they have every right to call it in.
Please don't tell me there's nothing you can do about it.
From a legal point of view, your former employer, XP Telecommunications, is within their rights to do so. It was stipulated in the contract that after the training, you would have to work for them for a minimum of 5 years or give them 6 months' notice prior to leaving.
And I'm obligated not to work for a rival company for 3 years?
Did you agree to it?
Yes, but I was desperate for a job. I didn't think much of it. What am I going to do?
We'll fight it.
Is there hope?
I'll do my best.
Hello, Tokara.
Hi, Cyrus.
You wanted to talk to me?
No.
Okay.
Actually, yes.
So?
Well, as you know, I'm an intern. And I've gotten the chance to work with most of the lawyers in this firm. Learning the ropes, so to speak.
Wow, good. And how's it so far?
So far, so good.
Yeah, have you worked with Elsie?
A little.
What about Joe?
Well, with Joe.
Talking behind my back?
In a good way, Joe.
I see. I hope Tokara is saying good things about me.
Actually, I was telling Cyrus here about the cases we've worked on together.
Of course, yes, you were. Hey, what happened last night? You didn't show up.
I worked late.
What about tonight? I can call the restaurant and reserve a table for two.
I have to go.
Looking for this.
This court should have been in session 10 minutes ago. I can't wait any longer. Clerk, shall we begin?
In the matter of XP Telecommunication Limited versus Vivian Njoroge, being a claim of for the damage cost 3 million Kenya shillings for the breach of contract, the court is in session.
Opening statements. I'm sorry, madam. Time is not a luxury the court has. 10 minutes is more than I can give. Begin.
Thank you. This case is all about breach of contract and nothing more. The plaintiff will show that there was a legally binding employment contract between the parties, which is enforceable by law or by binding arbitration. A contract is an exchange of promises with specific legal remedies for breach. Vivian Njoroge entered into a legally binding employment contract with XP Telecommunications, whose terms and conditions were clearly laid out in black and white, full bold print. We will establish that the contract was duly executed and that Vivian Njoroge is in violation of that contract by breaching two of its terms. One, she failed to give her employer 6 months' notice before her resignation. And two, she opted to join a rival company immediately upon leaving XP Telecommunications, whilst the contract she signed clearly stipulated no joining of a rival company in the span of 3 years. Well, the time has come for her to compensate her employer for breach of contract. It is as simple as that, Your Lordship.
I am sorry, Your Honor, for coming late, and without wasting any more of the court's time, I will go straight into my opening statement. The origin of contract law can be traced to the development of common law. Contracts are a medium through which parties willingly create legally binding commitments amongst themselves. Contracts are based on some legal principles, often cited in Latin, out of which consensus ad idem is the most important. It is a meeting of minds, an agreement amongst the parties. However, courts can and do intervene in situations where the parties lack the necessary capacity to contract, or if the contracts are trifling, illegal, or impossible. The key words in this case being trifling and impossible. To ask a telecommunications software development specialist not to work for a rival company for the period of 3 years after leaving her employ is nothing short of trifling and impossible, let alone oppressive. We will show that the terms of this contract were unduly oppressive and her decision to leave completely justified.
Traffic. I was going crazy. I liked the opening though.
All right, let's hear from the witnesses.
We call Mathalia and Kipchoge.
Yes.
What do you do for a living?
I'm the software development director at the XP Telecommunications.
What does software development entail?
Software development is the act of producing or creating software. Softwares are created for various purposes, but the three main purposes why the softwares are created is one, to meet the specific needs of specific clients and their businesses. Number two, to meet specific needs of personal or potential clients. Number three, for personal use.
I see.
Essentially, software development is the activity of computer programming, and it entails maintenance and writing of the source code.
So what does it entail, just computer programming?
Oh no, that was just a way of me simplifying it. In almost all cases, software development includes research, reuse, re-engineering, and almost all cases, activities that result in software products. For larger software systems, such as those that we deal with at XP, it entails a larger group of people, and some forms of procedure are typically made for its production. It involves many other departments as marketing, research and development, and the general management.
Also, you work with a team?
Yes, a well-dedicated and trained team.
Who trains the members in your team?
Training on the job is at the top of the list. We spend the probation time training our members, and those who catch well are taken to the next level.
Being?
Exchange programs. we send them to a mother company in the UK, where they undergo intense and thorough training to meet the needs of the organization and the client's demand.
So the training that an employee receives is specifically engineered towards software development in telecommunications?
Yes, and more specifically to our clientele.
How long does it take for one to be fully mature as a software development specialist?
Because of the foundation in computer science, 2 years.
2 years?
Yes, sir, 2 years.
I see.
We spend millions and millions of dollars investing in our employees. And with that huge amount of money, we expect something back.
Let us narrow down to this suit. Approximately, how much money was spent on training Vivian Njoroge?
Without billing in the man hours spent in training the individual, it approximates to 3.5 million Kenyan shillings.
A whopping 3.5 million?
Yes. In fact, if I were to add up the man hours spent in training her, it adds up to 5 million Kenyan shillings.
Oh, all that just in training?
Yes.
What is your guarantee that an employee will not jump ship at the crucial hour and you lose all that investment?
That's why we demand a working contract for 5 years.
5 years? Isn't that too steep?
Considering the millions spent, no. Besides, we are futuristic in development and that's very significant in our organization. The training one gets is relevant up to 2015, and this is just a sure way that our investment stays intact. Hmm. I see it pointless and in fact creates a total loss if we share all this with our employees and they go out and leak it to our rivals. There's no business sense there. The scientists spend many years in the labs coming up with this technology. And so, us as an organization, our work is to safeguard it.
Is that the reason for the exclusive 3-year clause?
Yes. We are protecting our technology. We are protecting our knowledge, for this is a very competitive world.
Indeed it is.
Why do you need 2 years to train a software developer?
Software development, as I said earlier, it entails many other departments, such as research, marketing, development, just but a few. Software product planning entails knowledge in multiple disciplines, and so our members are trained to fully encompass with the fields that are related to our core activity.
And you are the head?
Yes, I am.
Before Vivian joined XP Telecommunications, you had allocated 3 million shillings for her training.
Yes.
And she had no choice but to take it.
She was not coerced in taking up the employment at the XP Telecommunications. In fact, before she signed on the dotted lines, she was made aware of the terms and conditions and she knew the pros and the cons, and so she went ahead and signed it.
I am the human resource manager at XP Telecommunications Limited.
Thanks, Ms. Rachel Lamu. Tell the court, are all the employees at XP Telecommunications required not to work for any rival companies within Kenya until 3 years have lapsed upon leaving employment?
No.
And are all the employees expected to give 6 months' notice in their resignation letter?
No.
So the two terms mentioned above are not for everyone in the company?
No. 6 months' notice and the clause of not working for a rival company is only for the sensitive jobs. The departments that handle development of technology or software would ordinarily have such terms. Information, valuable information, is shared with the staff in these departments, and it is important that the information, skills or data, or anything in relation to the new products and service development stays within the company.
Oh, what is the importance of the 6 months' notice?
It is basically to allow for smooth handing over and, more importantly, completion of any ongoing projects.
And I guess the 3-year clause is for protection of skills learned?
Yes, protection and payback for the investment made on the employee.
I see. So, what is your average turnover in the software development department?
2 in 5 or so years.
That low?
Majority of the staff are content. The salaries are very competitive. The benefits are good. Not forgetting the bonuses every 6 months.
Too good to be true. So why did Vivian Njoroge leave your company?
That was her personal decision.
You mean no reasons were stated in her letter of resignation?
She was vague, but it must have been for the money. She was offered better money, I presume.
And you couldn't match it?
She did not give us the chance. The question was, or is, why PicTech Systems found her to be so valuable unless they want to tap into our research?
Vivian Njoroge gave you 6 months' notice.
Yes, she did.
But she was asked to leave before the 6 months were through.
That's because she was joining our biggest rival, PicTech Systems, which was against her contractual terms. She had access to our newest projects. Not only that, she was a member of the newest project in the department, a system due for launch in the next 2 years. She had access to the protocols, the data, and the research. We did not want to take that risk.
You asked her to leave before the 6 months were complete.
Yes. Immediately we learned that she was joining our rival company immediately after. And we proceeded to file a suit immediately.
You say, or rather believe, that the only reason she was leaving XP to join PIX was because of the money?
Yes.
You also say that she was of immense value to the department, especially because she was working on a new project.
Correct.
So why didn't you counter offer? Why, if she was of such significance to the company, didn't you as HR match the offer?
She already had a foot out of the door.
She gave you 6 months' notice. 6 months, which is more than enough time for you as HR to formulate a package motivational enough to make her want to stay.
She wanted to leave, and we were no longer assured of her loyalty.
You spent millions training her. Millions. She was leaving for a rival company in the middle of a new project, yet you couldn't spend some thousands to make her stay.
She wanted to leave.
And as soon as you accept her resignation, you slap her with a suit.
She breached the clear terms of her contract.
You didn't value her as strongly as you say you do. You accepted her resignation. You refused the 6 months' notice. And then you promptly kicked her out. Is that how a valued employee is treated?
If we did not value her, why would we spend more than 3 million training her?
It's protocol. Everyone who joins the software development department needs to be trained, and the average cost of that training is 3 million shillings. Fact is, you didn't value her. If you did, you wouldn't have let her leave. And this suit, this is just spiteful. Vivian Njoroge, how long were you employed at XP Telecommunications?
For a good 4 years. I joined the company on 3rd June 2006.
In what capacity were you employed?
I was a software developer.
Before your employment, were the two clauses in contention in court today relevant to you?
Yes.
So you were aware you had to give 6 months' notice?
Yes.
And you were aware you couldn't work for a rival company for the next 3 years?
Yes, I was aware. I agreed to it all.
You agreed to it? You signed for it?
Yes, I did.
So why are you contesting this suit? Why, if you knew all along, why are we here?
I am contesting it because I did not hold the managerial position. I was not privy to any new technology, and I was not trained on the futuristic software.
What makes you believe you're not as privileged in your team?
Because I was doing the groundwork. My assignments were basic and straight to the point. I did my task and handed it over to my line manager, who added whatever she had to add and passed it over to her line manager until it got to the director.
So you were satisfied you could work for a rival company?
I had nothing to steal or sell to the other company.
For 4 years, you were employed by XP Telecommunications as a software developer, and you resigned in the same position.
Sadly so.
4 years, no promotion?
No promotion. I was only given a bonus 2 times, while my counterparts were given 8 times. In fact, my line manager joined the company the other year, and he was promoted 2 years ago.
Is that why you sought employment elsewhere?
I was not making any progress. My career was stagnant. I did what any career-driven woman would have done.
At your new employer, PicTex Telecommunications, what position do you hold?
I'm a software development manager. The salary and the benefits I'm getting there are 3 times what I was getting at the XP. Finally, I did well to myself.
Yes, you did. Nothing further.
Do you still have a copy of the contract you signed during your employment at XP Telecommunications?
Yes.
Is this your signature at the bottom of the page?
Yes.
My lord, this is a copy of the contract signed by Vivian Jaroge on the 29th of May 2006, 5 days prior to employment at XP. Accepted and marked. This is another copy I made. Would you like to have a look?
No, thank you.
This is a full-page long contract. And at the bottom of each page, I can see your initials. What does initialing of at the bottom of a page imply?
That I read it.
So you read each page of the contract?
Yes, I did.
Including the termination of contract clause 4?
Yes, I read it.
Oh, you read it?
Yes.
And you did agree that in the event of you joining a rival company, before the 3 years had elapsed, you would in turn compensate your employer compensatory remedies to the tune of 3 million shillings. Did you or did you not agree to that as well? Because I can see your initials right here.
Yes, I did.
Here?
Yes, I did.
All right. Now stop wasting time and write to my client a check of 3 million shillings. This contract was binding. Don't waste our time and this court's time. Just pay what you owe. It is well settled that a contract being an agreement between two or more persons creates upon them an obligation to fulfill duties in this agreement. Now, this agreement creates a legal relationship of duties and rights. And if these obligations are not fulfilled, then stringent action could be taken against the offending party. In this case, it is our submissions that the court should interpret and apply the contract as it is and not rewrite it. We further submit that stringent action should be taken by this court on the breaching party, Vivian Njoroge. She must fulfill her part of the contract. There is no two or three ways about it. I rest my case.
It's true, and I agree with my learned friend, that the courts should not rewrite the contracts for the parties. But that is the only concession I make. I hasten to add that if a court should find the terms of a contract unfair or oppressive, it should intervene. Following termination of employment, as is the case with Vivian Jaroge's employment contract, there is no justification whatsoever for the employer to seek compensation to recoup what was spent on employees' training. After 4 years of diligently discharging her duties, the employer definitely made a return on his investment. This suit must fail, and the $3 million is merely meant to intimidate a weaker party. It is also unfair and oppressive to ban the defendant from seeking employment from a rival company within Kenya for the next 3 years. She will be rendered jobless or forced to apply for jobs that she is not trained for. Finally, I submit that the notice period prescribed in the contract is unduly long and the courts should moderate it. 1 month notice is more than enough for both parties.
Very strong arguments, I must say. I will deliver my judgment this afternoon at 2:30. This court is adjourned.
All rise.
It's good to have you back in court.
It's good to be back in court. What on the street has it that you've become a cougar? So here are we meeting you, seeing that it keeps you too busy to notice that you're running late for court.
I'm so out of here. But hey, let's do a double. You and Tara, me and my little boy.
Sounds like a plan. Early to be sure not the time you came rushing in from your afternoon tryst.
Is your mind always in the gutter?
Better to have it in the gutter than to you.
Okay. I will tell you all about him if you just stop it with the jokes.
You know, we want to meet him. I mean, from what I've heard from Tara.
Why? Are you afraid of the competition?
Elsie, see, you've got your groove on, eh?
I always had my groove on.
All rise.
In the matter of XP Telecommunications Limited versus Vivian Njoroge. This court finds the terms of the contract of employment between XP Telecommunications Limited and Vivian Njoroge as being unreasonable and calling for the intervention of this court. I find the claim of Kenya shillings 3 million by the plaintiff is unwarranted and is hereby dismissed. I also rule in favor of the defendant in regard to the plaintiff's prayer for an injunction to bar the defendant from seeking employment from a telecommunication company for a period of 3 years. Such an order would, in my view, be oppressive. I have reviewed the evidence relating to the duties of the defendant and find that the requirement of 6 months is unwarranted. I will find a shorter period of 3 months as fair. I therefore order the defendant to pay her former employer the equivalent of 3 months' salary in lieu of notice. This court is adjourned.
All rise.